Have you thought about buying a mini audio speaker? Do you like Apple products? Well, me too, because today we're going to open the new HomePod Mini. As you can probably tell, it comes in a cardboard box, which it is shipped with. You might notice that I've already opened this. Why? Because I didn't realize it was the HomePod Mini. And I know there's a special group of people who are super excited about a new unboxing video, so here's to my university friends. Upon opening, let's have a look. As you would expect, it is beautifully presented by Apple. The HomePod Mini is one of the smallest speakers you can buy. It's up there with the Alexa speakers and the Google Nest speakers too. Why did I go for that HomePod Mini? Well, I have an iPhone, I have an iMac, and I have a MacBook Pro. So having another part of the Apple ecosystem makes sense. And to be quite honest, it's a cool gadget and I want to see if it's any good. So let's get into it. Not suggesting you do the same, but I'm just going to swipe across the polythene with a sharp knife. Let's have a look. Let's not be too precious about that stuff. Okay, so again, as you found with a lot of the iPhone boxes, there's a lovely soft close, although it takes ages to open. How about that bad boy? Nice. So what have we got in the box? We've got the HomePod Mini speaker and charging cable, so it's connected, so it's not detachable. Put that there. What else have we got in the box? We've got the usual gubbins around all of the warranties and the details and how to get started. Okay, we'll come to that in a moment. And the charging plug. Outside of that, that's it. So let's put the nice box back together. Comment below whether you're the person that keeps these boxes or whether you throw them out. Personally, I keep them, which means I've actually just got a shitload of Apple product boxes sat in the loft. So write a comment below to tell me whether you are one of those people or not. So let's have a look. What have we got here? This comes with a USB-C charging cable. So let's open that. Nice long cable. What is it, about a meter and a half? Having a slight battle with the plugs. First thing you'll notice is it comes flat as a plug, which is super handy because it just means you can travel with it. USB-C fits in here and you just flick the plug up. It's quite satisfying. Right, let me just plug this in. So upon plugging in, the first thing you'll notice is it starts to flash. That just means that it's getting to do its thing. So should we follow the instructions? I think so. Connect to Wi-Fi and turn on Bluetooth on your iPhone or iPad with the latest software. As you can probably see, it's come up on the iPhone already as connect to the HomePod Mini, so let's click setup. Wi-Fi not connected, we can correct that. How about now? Let's open Wi-Fi settings. Bring your iPhone nearer HomePod to restart setup. Okay, how about now? Let's click setup, see what happens. Install the Home app. Okay, well let's install that. Which room is the HomePod in? Let's go kitchen. Happy days. Now it's going to do its thing. Do you want to try Apple Music? Let's go not now. HomePod can recognize your voice. Recognize my voice. Personal requests. Use personal requests. Setup. Continue. Agree to terms and conditions. Transfer settings. Center HomePod in the middle of frame. If we just hop... How about that? It is setting up and doing its thing. How exciting. So the HomePod Mini is the smallest range of the Bluetooth speakers that Apple produced. They've got the big HomePod, which is considerably more expensive. This was £99 at time of purchase, which is February 2021, and I think actually represents quite good value for a Bluetooth speaker. I know there are alternatives for people like Bose, and Sonos have just brought out their own one, or will land in the near future. That will certainly be one to test out, but in terms of an Apple product that will integrate within the Apple ecosystem, I think it's probably not bad. So the HomePod Mini...
I'm Siri. Welcome to HomePod. You can't tell, but I'm waving. To get my attention, say, "Hey Siri." Let's get started. Say, "Hey Siri, what can you do?"
It would be rude not to. "Hey Siri, what can you do?"
I'm here to help. Get to know Siri at apple.com.
So let's have a look. I've downloaded the Home app. Allow whilst using app. All of a sudden, it's brought up my accessories. So let's do HomePod Kitchen. It's doing configuration. I don't use the Home app for Apple just yet. I haven't got enough Apple connected devices, although it is certainly something that I'm looking at. It does give you the option to look through rooms and create automation. And if you've used anything like the Alexa series or the Google Nest, then you can create automations to turn lights on and off based on whether you've got smart devices. It's currently working out the HomePod configuration. If we just go to Home and click Add Scene, so no remote access configuring.
It's the planet. Nothing was fixed anymore.
Hey, Barack. As you might be able to tell, I'm listening to Barack Obama's audiobook.
And watching for the next turn of the wheel, bracing herself for calamity.
Really, there's obviously something going on between the two. Okay, so I've got the Audible app open. If I do connect to device...
And although I rarely had trouble falling asleep during my time in the White House, I'd be so tired that within 5 minutes of my head hitting the pillow, I'd usually be out cold.
Thanks,
there were nights when, lying next to Michelle in the dark.
So it also has an intercom function. I don't know whether you can see that. If you click continue, it means that you can also choose when intercom notifications are sent to the phone. So let's go when I'm at home and see what happens. Obviously, it's quite easy to send stuff to the HomePod Mini, and to be honest, the sound sounds pretty good. Sound sounds pretty good.
Let Me Love You, written by DJ Snake, Justin Bieber, Carl Rosen, Louis Bell, Teddy Mendez, Edwin Perez, Lumidi Cedeno.
There we go. So, I think it sounds pretty good. Really, if you do have one of these, make sure that you're connected close to a Wi-Fi signal. I think some of what's happening is that the signal is not very strong because the router is all over there. But to be honest, it's a very cool looking bit of kit and presented quite nicely. The sound quality seems to be pretty good. What's not to like? Is it worth £100? You could probably buy a cheaper Bluetooth speaker off Amazon, I'm sure. Will it fit as nicely into the Apple ecosystem? To be confirmed. You know, I'm a bit of an Apple fan, so it makes sense for me. Would I encourage you to get one? Entirely up to you. I think it looks pretty cool. It's another nice gadget to have in the kitchen, and being able to stream easily music and audiobooks from the iPhone through to the speaker whilst working or making supper, then can only be a good thing. And therein lies the unboxing and setup of the HomePod Mini. I think it's going to be quite a nice addition to the Apple ecosystem. I'm certainly looking forward to hearing the dulcet tones of Barack Obama play out as I'm making supper tomorrow, but should also be a nice easy way to play music in the kitchen. So that's it. Thank you, everybody. My name is Brendan. Please do click subscribe. Make sure the bell wobbles. Just means you will get the content the moment it's released. If you found anything in this video useful, please also push the like button. That would mean a lot to me. But with that, I am going to turn Barack back on and sit back and enjoy the rest of my day. And with that, I will see you all very soon. Cheers.